Alright, boys and girls, so from the last clip, you guys saw it. I finally had the Super H running good for more than 33 seconds. So, if you guys can see in here and see some of the dirt, some of you guys can take a guess as to what was going on. Some of you are probably still clueless. But the strainer or the water separator there, the inlet to it was pretty much plugged. It would just drip gas out of it, just steady. And that was it. So, took that all apart and cleaned it. And I didn't show it because it kind of happened at an inopportune time. Right along the road. So, yeah, it just got fixed and I finally ran it around and had a little bit of fun with it. And now it's going to be cleaned off from sitting in the barn and all the other projects that started around it. But, yeah, at least it's running good now and concentrate on the other stuff. And I know I'm very famous for it, and I keep talking about stuff and never do it, is the charging system. So I have decided I'm just going to get 12 volt on this. I'm not even going to screw with it anymore. So once I get some money here, start working again, I'm going to buy an alternator. I'm just going to put 12 volt lights in it and be done with it. And pretty much we'll go from there, guys. So till the next part on the Super H. Catch everybody later. Running pretty good. Something wrong here. I'll have to figure that out. Maybe that's where you actually need the rubber gaskets for. Sigh. That's what happens when you didn't take it apart. Yeah, well, we're getting places. Not Harvard, but places. Alright, boys. Converting Super H to 12 volt here. I have this is a 6 volt generator coming off. And there is a 12 volt alternator in this box, along with the mounting kit and stickers and a few other things for the Super H. I already ate the cowtails. Sorry, guys. So, just gonna get putting this on here and see what kind of problems I run into. I thought this was supposed to come with a belt, but I didn't see a belt, so. Thought it was supposed to come with instructions too. Don't see those. See what happens. I got the charging system put together on the H. It's actually charging. Nice. So according to that, it's charging like 10 amps or something. Yeah, it'd be about 10 amps. Nice, very nice. At idle, I'd say it's probably charging about 5. Gauge is flopping around a good bit. Could be because it's on side. But, oh well, it's working. It's not a genuine IH voltage or amp gauge, but the belt is very loose. I just put the old belt across. So, works. Took the voltage regulator off. I got one extra wire that went up to the generator, and it's up here hanging out. So, tidy everything up and be good to go. I gotta get the right length belt put on it. Steiner shorted me a belt. I gotta call them.